So let's create and run a Hello World script on our new Vagrant server. Before we do that, I'm just going to show you how to disconnect and reconnect to your Vagrant server, just in case you disconnected since the last lesson. So if you're still connected from the last lesson, simply type exit in the Vagrant server window and hit enter. This is going to take you back to our local machine profiles REST API in the Git bash. Now to reconnect, or if you restarted your computer and the Vagrant server is no longer running, simply type Vagrant up to start the server. It should be a lot quicker the second time because the server's already been created and Vagrant, all it needs to do is start the existing image. It doesn't need to download the image and install it on the server and run all these commands. It just literally starts the image that we were working on last. Once you've made sure that you've run Vagrant up and the Vagrant server's running, you connect to it by typing Vagrant SSH. And now you're connected to your Vagrant server. So Vagrant has a really cool feature where it synchronizes the project files of our local project. So that's the local directory which Vagrant is running from. It synchronizes it automatically to the Vagrant server. So any files we have here are going to synchronize to a folder on our Vagrant server called /Vagrant. So if you type cd change directory /Vagrant, it will take you to that directory. All right, from that directory, if you type ls, it's going to list all of the files in there. You can see that these files all exist in our project. Files that begin with dot are hidden files on Linux, so they're not displayed when you just type ls on its own. If you want to show all the hidden files, you need to type ls-all or -a for all. You can see that all the files here are the same as the files in our local machine. So any file that we change here in our project will automatically synchronize to our server. This is really useful when working with projects because it means we don't need to customize all of our files and work on our project using this command line interface. We don't need to use SSH or the terminal to edit our files. We can edit them on our local machine in a editor that we choose, in this case Atom, and it will synchronize to our server, and then we can just run the files on our server. So let's create a Hello World script and run this on our Vagrant box. Start by right-clicking the Profiles REST API location and click on New File. And we're going to create a new file called hello_world.py. Inside the hello_world.py, simply type the line print open bracket, open double quotation, and then a message. It can be any message. We're just going to type hello world because that's pretty standard in the developer world. Once you've typed the print hello world line, just save the file and then go back to your Vagrant server and type ls to list the files again. You can see that we now have the hello world script in our Vagrant directory. So this is because Vagrant automatically synchronized this with our local project. So the second we saved it here, it appeared on our server. All right, so now let's run our Hello World script on our server. So you run it by typing Python and then the name of the file we want to run, which is helloworld.py. Hit enter and you can see that it outputs the Hello World text. So that's how you create a file on our local machine and run it on your Vagrant server. Now, let's commit our changes to Git. So it's best to continue working with Git on your local machine and not on the Vagrant server. Although you can install the Git tools on the Vagrant server and use Git from there, it's best to run it from your local machine because then you get all the other features that Git bash offers. So I'm gonna load another Git bash window and we're gonna navigate back to our project directory. So cd workspace /profiles REST API, hit enter. And now we're back on our local machine. So this is our Vagrant server, our development server, and this is our local Git bash. Okay, so because we added new files, we need to use the Git add command to add these files to our Git repository. So type git add, whoops, and then dot. And this will add all of our files to our Git repository. Next, we're going to type git commit, and we're going to commit our changes to the Git repository. So type git commit hyphen am, that's commit all with a message, and type the message, added a Vagrant file and hello world script. Close the speech marks and hit enter. Now you can see that it's committed our files to our Git repository. If we go back to Atom here, these files that were green are going to change gray or white because the green files are files that have been added and haven't yet been committed. So they're new files. Okay, so that's how you create a Hello World script and you run it on our Vagrant server. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found it useful and I'll see you in the next lesson.